Hey guys, today I am going to be walking you through step by step on how to create this absolutely gorgeous evening gown for under $50. So stay tuned.
As we proceed to give you what you need.
All right, guys, here's a snapshot of what you're going to need to complete this project. Now, I will have everything listed in grave detail in the description bar, so please make sure you check the description bar before asking any questions. So grab your pen and your paper and let's get these measurements out the way. Your first measurement is your waist. You're going to divide your waist by 6.28, and that number is going to be B. Your C is going to be your desired skirt length. Mine is 41 inches. I'm going to add B and C together for my total width of fabric needed. Now, if that went too fast for you guys, you can always pause it. Starting on a clean floor, I'm gonna have my whole 10 yards sprawled out. I'm simply going to measure out 90 inches, which is 2.5 yards. Now, I was able to find tulle that's 108 inches wide. So all I need to do is just cut 2.5 yards for each layer. I'll be doing that 4 times. Now here's a great trick, you guys. I'm going to simply take some fabric softener and just dump like maybe a cupful into the sink, not filling the sink completely up, and I'm gonna put all 4 layers of my tulle in there and I'm gonna let that soak for about an hour. While that's soaking, I'm gonna go ahead and prep my lining. Now, this is how the lining looks when I get it from the Craft our sewing store, in which I got my fabric from Joanne. But as you know, I'm doing a maxi, a full length tulle skirt, and I want my lining to be long. So I'm gonna have to fold it on an angle so I can get the most out of the amount of lining that I have. Since my lining is not long enough, I'm going to have to cut my lining in 3 sections. I'll have 2 smaller quadrants in the back and 1 full quadrant in the front of my skirt. With your measurements, we're going to simply measure out our pattern for our first out of 3 pieces for the lining. As you can see, I'm doing a pivoted motion and I am marking my fabric exactly where I want my skirt to end. I already did the top part, which is where my waist will go. Once all my markings are placed, I'm going to simply cut along the lines or the dots that I made. And I'm going to use this as my blueprint for the next 2 layers. I'm also going to use this as my blueprint for the tulle as well. Here's how the first piece of the 3 pieces for my lining looks. Now I'm going to start working with my tulle. Remember, I have tulle that's 108 inches wide, and that's more than enough for me to get a full length skirt because I'm only 5'1". So I'm going to simply fold my tulle over and then I'm going to fold it over on an angle. I'm then going to take my measuring tape to assure that I have my blueprint, which is my lining, measured right so I'm not cutting it too short or too long. Once I get everything lined up, I'm going to simply go in and I'm going to cut my tulle to match. I'll do that for all 4 of my layers. This is called a basic circle skirt. Now, because this is a maxi skirt and I want it to be fitted, I am going to have to add a zipper in this tutorial. So here's how I do it. I'm going to simply take my zipper and I'm going to take it on my 2 halves that go on the back of my lining, and I'm going to measure out where I want the zipper to start and where I want the zipper to stop. I'm then going to pin down the length of my lining. This crease is going to be right in the middle of my skirt, which is perfect for me to put my zipper. I'm going to simply pin that. Now, when I get over to my machine, this is really important. I'm going to start sewing below where I want my zipper to stop. And I'm going to sew in a straight stitch, a normal, small, tight, straight stitch. Now, once I get down the length of the skirt, I'm going to simply do a back stitch and I'll be done with my small straight stitch. Now, the next section is going to be at the top. From the top of the skirt all the way down to where I want the zipper to stop, I'm going to be doing a basting stitch. Now, a basting stitch is basically taking a straight stitch but spacing the stitching out so far that it's very loose, and all it's basically doing is kind of just securing it together temporarily. So I'm going to go ahead and do my basting stitch now from the start down to where my zipper is going to stop. You can see here, that's the basting stitch, and then it goes into the small, narrow, straight stitch. See how loose that is? It's not very close together compared to down here. All right, off camera, I ironed that open like a butterfly so I can then pin my zipper in between or on top of that split where the basting stitch is. This is all gonna make sense in a second, I promise. So basically, I'm gonna pin the zipper exactly on top of that seam. Once the zipper is pinned down, I'm going to simply go and stitch my zipper on. I'm gonna go down the zipper, coming back over to the other side, and then I'm gonna come up the zipper. When doing this, it can be kind of tricky. You can get nervous that you're gonna stitch into the zipper, but don't worry about that. You're not going to. Because we did a light base stitching, I'm able to go in with my seam ripper and open that up. And this has now created a very invisible zipper. Okay, I'm gonna gather all the openings of my tulle and I'm going to layer them together, just like you're seeing, making sure everything is lined up. With the whole waist area pinned in together, I'm going to simply do a basting stitch. I'm not gonna do one continuous stitch, I'm gonna do two separate, one in the front half of the skirt and the other stitching in the back half of the skirt. Now, what you're seeing me do now is take the ends of the basting stitch and I'm pulling it to cause the skirt to gather. As you notice, I put my gathers in the back and I put the smooth part in the front. And this is so I can accent my bum, but keep the front of me very flat and flattering. When sewing, make sure you do not sew over your zipper. You're gonna wanna start on one side of the zipper and then sew to the other side of the zipper. Once the skirt is attached to the lining, you're gonna simply take a pair of scissors and you're gonna cut a small slit into the tulle. Now it's time for us to make the waistband. I'm gonna simply cut out 9 by 32 inches of the lining. Yes, we're gonna repurpose. This is how we're able to keep everything under budget. And I'm simply going to add my interface and I'm going to measure how wide I want my band to be. With wish stitch, I simply folded the bottom end of the band and I put the iron over it, which adhered it together. Now it's time to attach the band. I'm going to simply try it on and I'm going to pin it onto my skirt with me wearing it. This way I know that it's laying the right way, and when I go to zip it, I know that it's going to work and fit my frame really, really nice. So once I have everything attached, I have now folded my zipper down for all the excess zipper I had, and I have everything secure onto my skirt. I'm removing the excess zipper that I stitched down, and now I'm going to go ahead and finish off attaching the band. Make sure you backstitch, guys. So that's it. You're going to remove all of your excess thread and go back and clean up anything that you want to clean up. But yeah, so now it's time to pick your top. The one on the left is from Deb and it was only $7. The one on the right is from Target and I think it was like $12. I end up going with the long sleeve. I felt that it really just complemented the look. And so I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. It was a pleasure making it. This dress turned out absolutely gorgeous. I cannot believe I was able to make something so beautiful for such an inexpensive amount of money. So all you need is a little bit of time, a little bit of money, a lot of patience, and you can have something that you can definitely be proud of when you walk into the door of your event. How awesome is it to know that you made your gown that's one of a kind, no one else is gonna have it, so yeah. Party like a rock star. You guys are gonna definitely wanna stay tuned. I'm gonna be doing two more videos, one showing the makeup and the hair from this look. Also, if you haven't seen my last video, head on back and check that out. Also, head over to MA and the Hubs TV to see our latest vlog. Here's what you guys are saying over on the gram. As always, you can follow me on all of my social media, and you can always check me out over at www.themariaantoinette.com. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching. I truly appreciate it. Make sure you're subscribed, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.